Everybody, it's the Victa. It's time to continue the intrigue here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for the support on all the videos yesterday. Each video that was released yesterday doing very, very well, including the one step from Eden First Impressions. And who would have ever thought that the Sissy Mod video would have been very, very popular? Thank you all very much for continuing the like streak as well. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by Cyberdyne Model 101, which is a fantastic Reddit name. This one is, like, consistently one of the best memes that I see that always gets me. It's so good. Look, we don't take blind items. And also, somebody on that thread that this was lifted from said, if you think about it, Curse of the Blind is just, or Curse of the Blind item rooms is just a fancy dead end. I mean, it is true. Z-Day is going to be Lima, November, 2 Yankee, 8 Kilo, Kilo 6. We got Tech 0, an 18 tier delay. Woof. Yeah, that's pretty awful. I mean, Tech 0 is great. Let's not get it twisted. However, 18 tier delay is barely enough just to even get like a hint that we have a tier effect right now. Hail of Flies is fantastic, however. We also have the stopwatch, by the way, which is going to slow everything very, 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 very briefly. But an 18 tier delay is definitely concerning. There's a lot of things that could go very, very wrong. With such a low rate of fire, I should say. I wish it was a low tier delay. But a high tier delay means that our shots are going to be extremely important in terms of accuracy. And to top that all off, luckily we do have an elevated level of damage here with 3.71. That is, you know, not bad. We also got that half soul heart in there, so it was kind of worth it, I suppose. But we're going to need, whenever you get starts like this, you have to have one or the other. You can either have a really low rate of fire but high damage, or you can have a really high rate of fire but low damage. Either one of those scenarios is fine. What you can't have is a combination of both. If you have a really high rate, or if you have a really low rate of fire and also really low damage, that's when you start getting into lots of trouble. And thankfully, in this run so far anyway, I mean, we're only on floor one. But thankfully, we at least have, I don't want to say supplemental damage because that doesn't make any sense. We have damage that is adequate enough to handle the demands of early game Isaac here. Now, if we can hopefully get some maybe shot speed, that would also be kind of great. But really, the rate of fire is what's going to be holding us back. it's not a terrible way to start off Monday. I mean, we have plenty of HP. We've got a soul heart. Thank you, Halo of Flies. Halo of Flies does deal damage, by the way. That's one of the common misconceptions that I was guilty into thinking and believing. Oh my goodness, I got another random soul heart. Okay, well, we're going to hold back from this one just because obviously if we somehow lose this 1.5 soul hearts, we can at least have a backup one for our deal with the devil on the next floor. Now, ideally here, I would love to get something like, say, Squeezy. Again, damage would be nice, but I honestly would rather have a tier's up right now. Squeezy, toothpicks would be awesome. Wire coat hanger. I mean, any there's a number. Binky would be great. Any number of upgrades, of course, right now would be primo. Porn photo is another one. Divorce papers, if we actually had them in this save file, but we don't because we don't have the forgotten unlocked. People were asking me as well, would I consider doing a sissy streak? I don't know about that, because, I mean, it is a mod, and I can't just have, like, a mod. If I have a mod on one save file, they're going to be on all save files. And then we're going to run into the issue where if I'm playing Isaac and I accidentally hit the tilde key, it's going to bring down the console, and then it starts the whole discussion, like, oh, it's a modded run, rah. You know? And I prefer just not to do that. On top of that as well, the Sissy mod's great. I have absolutely no complaints about it whatsoever. Maybe not whatsoever. It would be nice if you didn't have to install another mod to stop the costume change, but that's more of the effect of the game design itself rather than the Sissy mod than Poggle did. But we'll talk about that in a moment. So we get Cat of Nine Tails. At least we got damage and shot speed. I'll take it. So 5.40 damage now is going to be beautiful. This very greatly illustrates my example that I was talking about earlier, in that if you have one, you at least need to be able to compensate for the other. Now, obviously, the player's not going to, you're not going to have any different, you have zero control over what items the game's going to give you, right? We're just talking about managing our expectations and knowing what can help us versus knowing what can't. And I think that that's a very good, that's a good skill to have in your repertoire. Whenever you're talking about being a better Isaac player, is identifying where you need to improve. What are the possibilities of you improving? You know, what different items could I get right now from this very moment that that could benefit me in the best way, in the biggest way? Being able to do that, it not only illustrates considerable knowledge of the game at hand, but also your ability to analyze the situations and understand, like, okay, this is what I need, this is what I need, this is what I need. And if you can get to that level, you'll find yourself really upping your Isaac game and managing. You'll be managing problems a lot better as well. Keeping yourself focused on what you need versus what you don't have, and versus what, like, you know, oh, this run is so terrible. It's like, yeah, I mean, everyone's, you know, am I happy with a run that starts with 18 tier delay? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Tier delay, I've said it before and I'll say it again. A low rate of fire will kill you faster than no damage will. 100% of the time. Absolute guaranteed. I do want to open up that chest, but I need to figure out where our secret room is. Considering we have Curse of Lost here, so we can't... It's not easily determinable, but if I can get some confirmation walls here, then I can suss it out, I'm sure. Okay, so it's still possible. It's still a possibility that the secret room could be to the right of here. Okay, we got there. We do have a golden key, of course, so obviously we can get in there. But I need to double check to see what room is opposite of this room here. Okay, yeah, this was the greed fight, so, or the gluttony fight. So most likely the secret room could be there. It's not guaranteed. But the reason why I'm harping on this room here is because obviously we can kill two birds with one stone here. If I drop a bomb, not only do we gain access to the secret room, but we also gain access to that chest. Now, I'm not going to drop it quite yet because there is still a possibility that we may need this bomb. One of the rules that I always talk about, and one that I frequently break, that you shouldn't break, this is more of a do as I say, not as I do sort of a thing, is if you only have one bomb and you've not, you know for a fact you have not gone through the entire level, do not use your only bomb until you know for absolute 100% certainty that you do not need it. There's going to be situations that arise where you use the bomb, you're like, oh, hey, I got into the secret room, and then like a room later you're going to find like two bombs that were reachable by just simply using one bomb. You know, that, and that sort of scenario can hurt you in the long run. Okay, so now we know that there's not going to be a wall that's above that secret room. So, I would reasonably assume that our secret room is to the south of that chest room. But first things first, we gotta go up against Ragman and get ready for a long fight. Now, Tech Zero, of course, is going to help out, but yeah, we really need to get our tiers right under control. Now, that's interesting that I don't know if Backstabber proc'd from the shot itself or if it was from Tech Zero, but something to keep an eye on. I tweeted about it last night, and I'm trying to get less involved with health stuff, my personal health stuff anyway, because it just makes a lot of people worry. But I did not have a good night last night at all. I could not sleep whatsoever. My nose was so clogged that I was having difficulty breathing, and so that was not fun. I did eventually finally get to sleep. I took some medication. And I took a couple of just hot showers to kind of loosen everything, and it did help. I'm planning on, the reason why I'm bringing this up though is not to scare everyone, but I need to get opinions because I've never actually had a humidifier, and my entire house, the one that I live in, as opposed to the one that I don't live in, because I have multiple houses. Belly button is not what we're looking for. Honestly, neither is tapeworm. I mean, tapeworm's fine, but and we get a non-double deal, double deal. All right. Well, at least we get a competent. item. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the hourglass. It's just the problem with the main problem that I have with the hourglass is that it just doesn't last long enough. Right, so, thanks to our powers of deduction, we were able to suss out the location of said secret room. And because we have the counterfeit penny now, which is our trinket, we should make every possible effort to find as many coins as possible. Even though we haven't been to the shop yet, we know that there's this gold... Thought we'd already been up here. We know there's a golden chest that's inside of the... well, somewhere in the level. Got a random dime show up. I'm happy about that. Don't really want to lose a soul heart here, but we also get a nickel. And Locust of War, no thanks. Thanks, but I think I'll pass. But anyway, I was looking for opinions on humidifiers, because I was told that if you suffer from sinus issues, from dryness, like if it's way too just dry, that's usually when your sinuses kind of like just clam up and they shut down. And last night was awful. That was one of the worst nights I've ever had in my entire life. I can honestly say that because I just could not fall asleep. I was like, I need to find a solution because I do not want to go through this again. And a couple of people that I talked to in real life anyway, they said that humidifiers would help out greatly with that. And our house is very dry, bone dry. So I'm considering getting one. I don't know if it's possible to get one delivered anytime in a timely manner. But I am curious to hear what your opinions are on it. For those of you who do actually own a humidifier, do you think they're worth it? The thing, this is the thing that I'm worried about, is that because I'm so like picky when it comes to like how like my sleep conditions are, I'm worried that it would actually disrupt my sleep even more. And what I mean by that is I'm worried that everyone knows that I obsessively take showers before I go to bed. I have to shower before I go to sleep. And it's mainly born out of the fact that I just don't like my skin feeling clammy. Like I really dislike it. And it distracts me enough to where it distracts me enough to where I can't fall asleep because I'm all just sitting there thinking about it. And I'm worried that a humidifier, thank you, Halo Flies. I'm worried that a humidifier will make me feel a little sweaty. I don't know. I might have the wrong impression of a humidifier, I guess, because maybe they don't do that. I know that they're just designed to put moisture in the air. And I'm not saying that my room's going to turn into like a swamp or something, you know, but I also don't want like the air to just be super soaked. And I live in one of the most humid places on like the planet. At least in the United States. South Texas is known for being pretty humid. I mean, we are living in a hot bathroom essentially for most of the year, which is the reason why I hate hot weather. And I think that someone else made a suggestion that I also look at getting a diffuser or something like that, which I'm totally down for. Like I love peppermints. Peppermints is definitely my go-to. I have like tins and tins and tins of peppermint icebreakers. So when my allergies get really really bad and like my sinuses sort of clam up, I can at least, you know, pop a couple icebreakers in there, and then I'm okay for like maybe a minute. Yeah, that was a super jump from the champion's fighter, which we always know and love. Yeah, just looking for opinions on that. Have some really good questions of the day. We didn't actually have yesterday. We didn't have a whole lot of questions of the day. So it's possible that maybe not many people are interested in it. It's also possible that that's just a product of it being Sunday. I'm not entirely sure yet. I don't have enough data to analyze, you know, the effectiveness of what the channel, what the Mosh Pit likes and what they don't like. All that stuff is a constant learning experience, which is another fascinating thing about this job, is just you learn more and more. You know, there's so much there are so many statistics that run on the back end of a YouTube channel that you guys and gals probably have never even heard of before. And I'm not saying that in a derogatory way, like you're not capable of understanding these. I'm just saying you won't believe how many stats there are. I mean, I can tell on any given video that's posted a revenue share from AdSense, I can see exactly where people are tuning in from. I can see how long they've watched ads. I can even see if they did or did not click on an ad and where those ads were delivered from. I mean, the sheer amount of analytics that Google provides is just it'll throw you for a loop. I mean, I'm not really a stat junkie. You know, I enjoy watching. I used to, in a dorky way, whenever there'd be a new baseball season, I would I'd have my own little notebook. This is before the internet. I would have my own little notebook that I would have, and I'd be like, oh, he pitched. Like, I have a little tally of how many pitches that a pitcher would throw, just because I thought it was interesting just to keep track of that sort of thing, you know. One year when I was young, I was pretty young. I wanted to keep track of how many breaths I took in a year. Well, that lasted for a whole maybe hour. So I was like, okay, this is not. Again, keep in mind, I'm talking maybe 6 years old, or seven. I might have been seven. I don't. I was old enough to remember, but I'm not old enough to remember how old I was. The only thing I do remember is that I didn't really think about the logistics of counting my breaths as I was sleeping. And that kind of discouraged me because I was like, oh, wait, yeah, I should probably have a way to deal with that. And I didn't. And then I just gave up. So, you know, I like numbers, but man, the sheer amount of data that YouTube gives you is redonkulous. And yet they still can't tell us what does and what doesn't affect our channel's monetization. But if you're wondering why I didn't use the stars card, by the way, it's because I'm saving that for a situation where we can skip out of a mob trap room or boss trap room. Let's see what we get out of this boss first. I mean, we're not gonna get the boss rush. That's just that. Just picture that and just let it float out of your brain. It's not happening. Rag Mega. And Guppy's Head, of course, combined with Nun's Habit, is at least going to give us some sort of retaliatory power against stuff that damages us. Nun's Habit's going to give us one charge every time we take damage from something, kind of like that, because that whole ricochet made sense. And yeah, kind of like that, too. But, dude, my mind is so blown. I don't know how that first ricochet shot even landed, but I'm sure we'll watch the replay of it. Speedball is absolutely a necessary upgrade for us. We get a shot speed upgrade. More importantly, we get movement speed. Since we did not get a deal with the devil, I am going to go over here and steal the golden chest. When I say steal, I mean I'm just going to... Okay, well... When I say steal, I mean I'm going to take the chest without having to do the room. And we essentially just traded an Emperor card for a Stars card, which is a good trade. To be sure, because we all know the golden rule about Emperor cards. They close the deal. They get you the win. They're your ace starting pitcher. Okay, well, maybe not ace starting pitcher, your closing pitcher. Normally you wouldn't call, I guess they do use the term ace starting pitchers, but it's not nearly ubiquitous as closing. Here's the maze, hooray. Okay, so let's talk, while we're on the subject of analyzing stuff, let's talk about what are we facing on this run. Yes, my nose is still stuffy, if you couldn't already tell. just tears. I mean, we're not in danger of dying anytime soon. But if we don't get some kind of meaningful tiers upgrade soon, we're going to start running into problems. Our shot speed is adequate for where we are in the game right now. 1.30 is phenomenal. I mean, we've had runs that go a lot slower than that. The dreaded low tiers rate a low rate of fire, I should say, and also a low shot speed is that that's the combo that just that puts you to sleep, man. And those are the worst feeling runs possible. So at least we have shot speed going for us. Tech Zero, of course, is an excellent tier effect, but we can barely utilize it because we're not firing shots off rapidly enough. If the question is, would I reroll this run? Abso-freaking-lutely. Although it would be difficult for me to give up Tech Zero. The thing is, I think this is a misconception with people as well on the subject of rerolling in Isaac. Just because you reroll doesn't mean that you're going to get better stats. Your stats are going to be obviously directly tied into what items you roll. So, for example, we could theoretically reroll this run and still have 18 tier delay. If we got, you know, 8 items that didn't give us any tiers up. I mean, that's just how it works. So the idea of a reroll being the end all be all in terms of like bailout is unrealistic, because frequently it does help out more than it hurts, but it doesn't always guarantee success. No, I'm not happy that we took 2 hearts worth of damage in there. At least we know where our secret room is, right here. I have messed with the encoder settings a little bit on OBS, and I did also go into the BIOS and mess with some of the CPU voltage stuff too, because I was starting to get the really annoying blue screen of death whenever it was talking about it's the same BSOD that I was seeing a couple months ago when I first discovered that the power was being unnecessarily throttled by the motherboard in the BIOS, I should say. So I went back and I played around with those settings, and I haven't really gotten the high encoder setting problems in a while, but the game still stutters, and that's the standard frequent stutter that we've seen for the past year now in Isaac. Go to the store here. The battery is going to allow us to store more than one charge on our space bar item. We get Diplopia. Man, this is tough. We need 6 cents to make this work. Because ideally I want to get 2 mystery gifts. Now we can only take 1 into the devil deal or the angel deal. Ironically, my reflection could be useful when we're talking about my reflection. Is my reflection a range down though? I think it is. I don't know, man. We may be taking my reflection here. The more I'm thinking about it, I'm like, we have the shot speed for it, and it would prolong our tiers travel time, which means that we're going to be able to actually get some effect from Tech Zero. But the problem that I have with my reflection is that I'm very ugly. But also, because that it severely limits the range that Isaac has to work with. And I don't know if that's worth it or not. This boss drop will determine a lot of things here. But before we go into the boss, we have to figure out what we're going to do with this mystery gift. Because it would be nice to have, like, let's say, for example, we get Goathead. Like, if this is the Fallen, we'll get Goathead. And then after that, we can get, like, you know, we can go back into the Devil Deal and get, like, the Pact or something from the mystery gift. Yeah, get ready to spend a lot of time here in this room, kids. Thank goodness we got Speedball. See, that's what I didn't want that Globin to do. I didn't want him to go that side. Okay. You can't let them split up. And, oh, hey, we got one. You gotta give him a little tap there. Right as they get close to Isaac, you have to tap him one more time. Otherwise, you're not gonna have enough space to squeeze through there. Okay, we need 5 cents. The reason why I say 5 cents here is just obviously because I mean we're going to buy Diplopia. We need Diplopia to make the double mystery gift thing work. This is a run where we've got to get kind of creative here. And I'm not 100% sold on my reflection yet. I'm leaning towards... I mean, for cautionary reasons, I'm leaning towards not taking it. But I'm sitting here thinking about it. I'm like, but what if it's actually good, though? Like, what... Because, I mean, if we get blanked on this boss and we don't get a meaningful devil deal or angel deal, we're in some trouble. Two diamonds would be awesome, but it's not a two of diamonds. Okay. Is there any fires or anything that we haven't shot yet? We would need to get 3 pennies and all of them proc with the counterfeit penny, but or we can just get nothing. I guess that's fine too. I don't know where the super secret room is yet. Super secret room rarely ever has any money though, so I'm not banking on that. Not here, I can tell you that there, brother. Probably here. If not there, then here. Yeah. Okay, this is good. Possibility. Don't ever shoot me again. I don't remember what episode it was. Some champion of the mosh pit can find it. There was an episode where I very spitefully go back. Like, I was leaving... I think it was in a devil room. I was leaving a devil room, and a demon fire took a shot at me, and I got, like, really, really upset by that, and I had already left the room, and I went back in the room just to shoot the demon fire that took a shot at me. But yeah, that's Peaks and Victor right there. There's a bomb here for the keeper. We got nothing for it. Okay, but thankfully we are able to get Diplopia and the mystery gift, and maybe even more here. So I'm going to buy. I mean, it doesn't matter which one we buy. I'm gonna buy this. Get a second Guppy's head, which does not count as a Guppy item, unfortunately. So, ideally, here's what we're looking at. Ideally, what we want is we want the Devil Deal to give us something meaningful. And then, we have a way of going back into the Devil Deal to get the second mystery gift, and then bring it in there and use it. That's a lot of work for an item that you may not think is that important, but this is a pretty pivotal moment here in this run. Mystery Gift has you've got a huge chance to be a big time player here, Mystery Gift. Diplopia, I mean the counterfeit penny and Diplopia, they've done their part. Now it's time for you to step up, son. You want to be on this team? You want to join this organization? We have a certain level of pedigree that we expect from all of our superstars here that we need to see you producing. So you can see here, I'm trying to cut through Gertie Sr. here with Tech Zero. But, yeah. I told you it was going to be a slog. 18 tier delay is quite awful. We would be in a lot worse situation if we didn't have Guppy's Head, and especially if we didn't have Tech Zero. Our damage is still adequate, but as you see here, our DPS is not. I cannot believe that not only hit us, but got past Halo Flies. That must have been an angle where, like, it doesn't matter. I mean, it's 27 minutes and we're on caves too. We've certainly had worse, but it's been a while since we've had this. So, mystery gift, we really need you to come up with, like, the pact, Mom's Knife, Brimstone, Maw of the Void, anything, Zack Dagger, please. Zack Dagger would be perfect for us. If we can't get a Tears up, give me Zack Dagger. Oh my goodness. Well, that's a nice little pick me up there, I've got to say. Holy Grail is also very nice. Fortunately, we're not able to get back into the Angel Room. But Godhead is nice. Now, before you get the wrong idea, there's nothing wrong with this situation. What I'm about to say is said purely from the standpoint of it could have been much better. Godhead doesn't have a huge effect on this run right now. I'd say you're one for one, Mr. Gift. You know, you stepped up, and I appreciate that. I'm not gonna poo-poo that. Godhead is extremely rare. If we get piercing shots, this will be huge. Actually, my reflection is a range up. I did not know that. It's also a shot speed up, which is something else I did not know. So we should have taken that a long time ago. It shows you how much of a prejudice I have against my reflection. Because it's so ugly. So, with my reflection here, the idea for the strategy layer on this was that, and this is before we had Godhead, obviously, is that we want to synergize around Tech Zero, obviously. And I did not know. I mean, I never take my reflection ever, unless if I have piercing shots, because it is such a huge gamble. You essentially just like Ipecac or anything like that, just forget about it. Don't even think about taking my reflection, or vice versa if you have one or the other. But this was one of the very few times that I can remember where my reflection actually was making sense. And now we combine that with Godhead, and on top of that, find out that my reflection is actually a shot speed up and a range up. That's huge. On top of that, we also got flying from the mystery gift, which means now we have a full range of mobility that will allow us to sort of just chain together these really crazy Path of Exile looking shots all over the screen, and that's huge. So, you know, even though we have a 21 tier delay, which is just horrible. Okay, I guess I may have like tapped the reroll machine, but I'll take a black Kendadu. But even with a 21 tier delay, we're moving fast enough to where we can manipulate Isaac's position and sort of boomerang moonshot these crazy tier effects here. So this is good. This is good. Godhead was the most unexpected best upgrade we could have ever not hoped for. I want someone to write that previous sentence I just said down in the comments and just read it, because it's gonna read like one of the most ridiculous, nonsensical sentences that's ever been imagined. And that's me in a nutshell right there. Help! This is me in a nutshell. Ooh, yeah. Okay. It wasn't funny before Austin Powers did it. Obviously, now you can see why piercing shots would be so amazing here. Godhead with piercing shots is just so strong. You combine that with the fact that we have Tech Zero, and you're talking about a perfect case scenario where you're going to see a huge power spike very, very quickly. Pop's Curse is poison bombs. Not really something that we're looking for, but I'm glad to have them anyway. 26 bombs will allow us to at least skip through a lot of the rooms that we don't want to be in. Happy Monday. I also need to go. Super Secret Room is located above the above this room. It's to the left of the previous room that we were in. On a programming note really fast, because last night was so terrible, I did not get a chance to record Lobotomy Corporation today. Normally I try to record Lobotomy Corporation on stream, but that just wasn't happening. So Lobotomy Corporation is going to be a little bit light this week. I hope that the series can end this week. I really do. Get another angel deal, which is surprising since it was only 40%. And Mom's Coin Purse, and we also get Guardian Angel. Or Swarm Protector, I mean. Swarm Protector, it's a good third orbital. Okay. Man, would love to have a Tears Up, though. Sure would love a Tears Up. Dicta. What? Why don't you take pills, Dicta? I mean, yeah, I could. I could also get a Tears Down and make this run even more insanely not optimal. There's nothing minimally exceptional about this run other than the fact that we have Godhead. I will say, in light of everything that's been happening on this run so far, we have three very good synergies and the most unlikely of superheroes to save this run. Tech Zero, we all know and love. Everyone loves Tech Zero. If you get Tech Zero, you're just happy. Godhead, if you actually get a chance to see it, and assuming you have it unlocked, of course, everyone gets excited. It gets thrown up in the thumbnail. Everyone loves it. My reflection, no one, at least for me anyway, no one expects anything from my reflection.
No bleeding.
Actually, surprised it's not there. And the three of them are turning this run into something special in its own unique way. But just imagine if we get a Tears Up. I mean, if we get a Tears Up and, like, a dream scenario, we also get, like, say, Death's Touch or something, or just any kind of piercing shot whatsoever, this run's over. It's already over. Now, we're out of the danger zone, of course. Guppy's head's also been producing, combined with, taking damage, thanks to Nun's habit. Has been producing very well for it. It's giving us results. The intended result, but that's something that you expect in this combination of items. I would never have expected my reflection of all things to really bring home the team, the glue that adheses the team together, sort of thing. We don't really need any more red heart HP. Unfortunately. Unless if we just get some super overpowered, the lamb streak is going to be ending here and on three or whatever we're at. Okay, so there's the boss room. Now if we could just find... There we go. The shop and the item room, which is what I was looking at. Just give me a Tears Up. That's all I'm asking. Just one. Give me one Tears Up. Kenyon Mushroom would be great. It would lower our damage by a lot, but it'd be worth it because the Godhead Aura does so much damage by itself. Or we could take Anemic. I mean... Yep. I don't want to take Chaos here because this is our last store and we don't have enough money to really make a a worthwhile push, so. I will take Potato Peeler only for the fact that I want to have a damaging orbital that isn't Swarm Protector. There's nothing wrong with Swarm Protector, just to be clear. But it's not what I think of it when I'm like go to orbital source of damage. I'm more adept at using the Cube of Meat for an offensive orbital rather than Swarm Protector. Just because you rarely ever see Swarm Protector. Purple Fires generally have a pretty high rate of payout. All we gotta do is get to the chest is all. So Cube Meat here, this eliminates the need for us to use our tears as our only primary source of damage now. And again, since I am so accustomed to using Cube of Meat for offense, we're okay. You get a Devil Deal, surprisingly. And we also get damage. I don't know if Void matters. We're only going to get one more item pedestal here from here on out. And if it's a horseman like Death or Conquest, it's not going to produce something that we can void. I'm going to take Dark Matter because it's a damage up, and I'm going to stick with Guppy's Head. And I'll talk about why in a moment. So the reason why I decided to go that route is because of the fact that we have Nun's Habit. Raising our base damage here is, in my opinion, the right thing to do. Because if we do take damage, like we have in this room, we're able to produce flies that will help eliminate the threats faster than once they appear. Take the Hermit card here. Of course, I am going to go back and get our Emperor card. I just wanted to not be in that room. I also really don't want to be in this room, if I'm honest. Ooh, man. Bloody Crown now. Now the game is just trying to make me look like a fool for not taking Void. The Bloody Crown, it will give us one more item room on the next floor. Bloody Crown's a trinket that will give you a guaranteed item room in the womb. Not for the map you're already on, but on the next floor. And it's one of the best trinkets in the game because it just straight up gives you an item room. There's not many other trinkets that can do that. You know, the Silver Dollar is one of the few ones that comes to mind where it's like, yeah. you talk about opportunities and the like. Silver Dollar is going to get you there, but even more so, it's going to be Bloody Crown. Decided to go in the Curse Room here because it's only going to cost us 1 HP. But, this is what our life would be like if we didn't have Tech Zero in this room right here. This is me just trying to put out the fires with the tears. There we go. Stars card and another Stars card. Well, that was fantastic. Thought about bombing my way out of here, but I'm gonna save it for the next floor. Hookworm doesn't really matter. It's not like Ringworm. I don't think it gives you a tears up, but I can check after I'm done these brains here. Nope, just gives you a range up, and I don't know what it's doing to I'm not sure what it's doing, but honestly, I kind of like it. My Reflection does some weird things with the tier effects. I mean, Mama Gertie, I'm probably going to take a hit here or two just using the orbital. Obviously, with flying, our biggest threat is gone. We don't have to worry about the spikes on the ground. I don't actually know if I'm actually hitting her. If our movement speed was fast enough as well, I'd be able to manipulate the shots even more, and we get yet another HP upgrade. I'm only taking it for the shot speed. This rain in HP upgrades. How many have we had now? One? Two? Just two. Why does it feel like we've had more than that? Maybe it's because we just haven't had any other meaningful upgrades. I don't know where that first shot went. But yeah, more shot speed here means that More shot speed means that we're going to be able to hopefully get more tiers out at the same time. I'm not gonna take the left hand. I'm just not going to. I need to remind myself that we have Bloody Crown. So don't leave this room, or don't leave this floor without going to the item room. Just don't do it. Ideally, we would have enough movement speed to kind of just, like, shoot on by here, and then let our tiers kind of boomerang follow us, and because of the Godhead aura, we'd be able to essentially eliminate anything that they touch. But our movement speed is not adequate enough for that. Neither is our tiers rate. And at this point, we shouldn't really expect ever getting a tiers upgrade. I mean, we're so far down the line from needing, like, the optimal time has passed for a tiers upgrade. I mean, I'd still take one for sure, but, you know, I think that we sort of have to just comply with the idea of we just don't get tiers up anymore in this game. As we're down to Polar Invincibility now, Euthanasia, which is not going to help us out that much. I could donate some bombs there to the bomb beggar, but eh. I'm going to drop one on the keeper here just to up our chance. We get a steam seal, lol. Getting a fair bit amount of flies here, but I am going to get out of here now that we've successfully confirmed that there's nothing to the west or north. You know, these are the type of runs that you got to see all the way through, and managing expectations is a big one. Saying, okay, well, besides the obvious, what can we expect here? You know, more damage would be nice, certainly. Movement speed would be nice. I think that's all I have to say about that. So let's complete the trifecta of crapola on this floor by missing an 80% deal with the devil. Oh, that would really just take the cake, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it? Sure would. Satanic Bible is certainly something. Thing is, we don't really need... I mean, it's nice to have. I suppose because we have Nun's Habit, I will take it. Thank you, Guppy's Head. Guppy's Head, you the real MVP, though. Extra special shout out to Guppy's Head for making this possible. Without Guppy's Head, we would have been in a whole lot of trouble. You know, just gotta take the good with the bad. I would do the nerd voice right now, but I physically cannot. global D20. Good. Get Mom's Pearls. Doubles our keys. Sure. I mean, we might as well take them. Yeah, we'll go ahead and... I mean, I don't know if Hookworm's actually doing it for me. I like having the smooth curve, the transition of the ellipsis whenever we're throwing out our shots there, instead of the janky, like, erratic movement of Hookworm. That would be awesome. The pushpin is interesting because pushpin gives us a piercing shot every now and then. So we'll get brief glimpses of what this run could have been had we had better tier effects to go with the synergy. If it procs. I mean, it has to proc first. And given our low tier, our low rate of fire, you know, just keep an eye out for it. It's gonna... Blink and you probably still won't miss it. Another soul heart here. Again, we can freely use our we can use our bombs liberally here, just because of the fact that, again, remember we have the an Emperor card. Okay. That's super. Alright, let's go check out to the south of here. This them here, Isaac Run. I love when that happens. Those poison, if you're wondering where those poison flies are coming from, it's coming from the Locust of Pestilence. Locust of Pestilence, Alex. Yeah, see that right there, you saw what those tears were doing, how they were kind of like, oh, wow. Whenever Euthanasia actually procs, it's good times. But you saw a little bit in that big room there where we quickly zipped on by, and then we had that trail of damage behind us with the shots catching up to Isaac. That was... That was the strat that I was referring to when I was talking about our movement speed. You know, you just have this wave of damage that trails behind Isaac like a couple seconds after he's already been there. Not going to take the Eternal Heart. There's no reason for it at this point. But we are going to get a win. It's mostly due to the fact that we had Guppy's Head and Nun's Habit. It's a fantastic fantastic combo. But definitely cannot go without saying, you know, this holy trinity, the new holy trinity of Godhead, My Reflection, and Tech Zero has really, really surprised me. Going to use our human meat here for DPS purposes. Now we don't have to worry about the angel fetuses. We can back off because we're going to do the same thing against Blue Baby, and I don't want to lose all of our HP before that happens. That would be slightly suboptimal. I don't think I've ever lost a Godhead run ever. But this isn't your excuse me, I didn't mean to cough in the microphone there. I try to turn my head in time. This isn't your typical Godhead run, though. I think that goes without saying. You don't see too many Godhead runs that are lasting, like, upwards of almost an hour. You know something had to go kind of screwy if we had a Godhead run in the thumbnail, but an hour-long video. Unless if we had, like, you know, 3 victory laps or something like that. So, Did we go through an entire run without seeing a tiers upgrade? Yes. 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 And yes. I mean, technically, anti-grav is a tiers up. Not a great one. And PH Dizzle gives us a range up. Hooray. Hooray. Terrific. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Subscribe and ring the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos go live here on YouTube. And again, thank you all very much for the continued support in the comment section with the Question Victus stuff. If you're still, if you want, let me know if you have ideas as well. If you have more interesting ideas for the comments and the Question Victus stuff. For now, I'm going to keep it, and we also are going to be changing the hashtag since it's a brand new week. I think this time around our hashtag will be hashtag, let's say hashtag humidifier. Yeah. So submit your questions this week for hashtag humidifier. And it doesn't have to revolve around humidifiers. I'm just changing up the question tag. Just keep it lively, keep it festive, keep it active. And I'll try to get to your questions. The more people that ask, obviously, the less frequent the chances that you can actually get your question asked. But yesterday's video, as I said at the top of this video an hour ago almost, we didn't have a whole lot of questions. So, you know, whether it's attributed to either it being Sunday or just people are just losing interest in it, I don't know. Let me know. I'm always reading. I'm always open for feedback, and I'm always interested in that kind of stuff. I have a very weird. I'm not sure what's going on with the synergy with anti-grav. I thought that we would just leave them in, like they would just be hovering in the air, but apparently that's not what happens. Apparently they slingshot around. kind of cool, I guess. What a run. So. Yeah, so thank you for watching, everyone. Remember, let's keep up that like streak goal and keep up with the comments. I'm going to answer a couple questions here as we round out the Question Victa hashtag. Diamond Sniper says, what's your subscriber goal for the channel, or how big would you want it to be? I don't really have a subscriber goal. Even at 100,000, I didn't really set one. So I don't have. It's not that I don't aspire to have a large YouTube following. It's just that the numbers have never really been something that I focused on. Inferno says, did you unlock Greedier with Isaac, or did you finish other characters then unlock Greedier? I unlocked Greedier, I think, with Isaac, and then I got all the unlocks just going through every character that was unlocked, that was actually there. Ipecac asks, why do you not like followers in Isaac? I don't like followers for the most part because, generally speaking, they contribute to the conjoined transformation, which is not exactly ideal in most scenarios, and I'd rather just not have to worry about stopping my fire in case I plant a bomb and they may like shoot it back towards me. And finally, Will asks, what is your favorite part about being a YouTuber or streamer? Being able to work from home and interact with people, with so many more people than I ever would have in my entire life, is truly one of the best, most rewarding things about this job. Thank you for watching, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.